Hello, good morning everyone. So since we're scheduled for a recorded lecture, we are scheduled for a synchronous lecture for this meeting, and for us to catch up with the remaining topic for this subject, we'll just have to go with a recorded one. Okay, so our topic for today is regarding the social engineering and phishing attack. And I hope to finish also the DDoS attack, no? So let's just have a quick overview with regards to what are those considered as social engineering. So if you can open your module, you will read there that when we talk about social engineering and phishing attack, these are techniques used by criminals to manipulate individuals into divulging sensitive information, no? So basically, ang concept itong social engineering is that they're collecting important data such as, of course, included na yung login credentials, no? And after gaining access of this important information is that they're going to take advantage of that, or they're going to exploit those collected information. Now, so marami tayong iba't ibang uri ng mga cyber attack, no? And since we are talking about social engineering, no? Let's discuss that first, then we go with phishing attack. Dito sa social engineering kasi, no? They're trying to manipulate individuals o yung mga end users natin, yung mga users ng technologies natin such as yung mga may online banks, or di naman kaya is merong mga online account where usually money is involved. They're manipulating them kasi the concept of social engineering is really a psychological attack, no? So they will manipulate them, no? Pagsasamantalan nila through the different methods that we are going to mention, no? Para makakuha sila ng confidential information. Now, if they have, and when we talk about confidential information, we basically are referring to passwords, no? Login credentials, your emails, your IP address, no? Your password, your PIN code, your OTP, no? And so on. So, yun yung mga gusto nilang ma-access, no? For social engineering, no? Pag nakuha nila o nagkaroon sila ng access sa mga ito, ay pwede na nila ngayong i-compromise yung security ng mga accounts natin, so they could do whatever they're planning to do, and most likely, sabi ko nga dito, the purpose is to exploit, no? To exploit. Okay, so basically we have here different methods in social engineering, included dyan yung tinatawag nating pretexting, no? Pretexting, impersonation, yung mga quizzes and surveys, no? Or it could be through baiting. So when we talk about pretexting, it is a method of social engineering. Kung saan is they come up with a scenario. Kumbaga, nagpapanggap sila, or they have this already a fabricated scenario, no? That they use in order to gain information from the target. Such as, for example, na magpanggap sila na kakilala nyo, no? Magpanggap sila na sila ay, for example, is a delivery rider, no? Wherein you need to provide some information para ma-access mo yung kanyang yung pinapa-deliver sa iyo, no? So they have that already. Ito yung mga they could do that through text, no? They could do that through phone calls, no? That they are coming up with fabricated scenarios. Say, for example, biglang may tumawag sa iyo, then sabi, your Facebook has been hacked and I'm here to help you, something like that. So meron silang script, no? Na sinusunod, meron silang mga stories, back stories na binibigay para nang sa ganun ay maging kapanipaniwala yung kanilang scenario. Say, for example, naka-receive ka ng emails or messages na nagsasabi na nanalo yung SIM card mo o yung cellphone number mo ng a certain amount, no? At kailangan mong ibigay yung pangalan, kailangan mong maibigay yung iyong bank account para lang sa ganun ay doon nila ipadala yung napanalunan mo. All of those usually are part of the so-called social engineering, no? Particularly doon sa method na tinatawag nating pretexting. Okay? Then yung isang method naman natin is the so-called impersonation, wherein they will be pretending not to be someone that the target knows or the target trusts. No? Usually, magpanggap silang superior mo, no? Magpanggap sila na superior mo. Kasi pag mga ganito kasi medyo ang tao, the psychology of a person kasi, no, is madali siyang maniniwala, madali siyang mag-oblige, no? Kasi nga superior niya yung supposedly kinakausap niya. So those who fall from this, na usually will provide the information that is being asked, no, yung hinihingi sa kanila nung taong nagpapanggap. So with that, they could be able to have an access on highly personal information, no? Say for example, may biglang tumawag sa'yo, sabi mo, paki send na sa akin yung birthday ni ganito, yung address ni ganito, yung name ni ganito, no? Ako ang head ninyo, something like that, no? So they tend to impersonate person, pretend to be someone, okay, so that they could have or they could get the trust, no? And if they have the trust, they can now exploit the person by asking for some information that are the confidential, okay? So that is impersonation. Then we have also yung quizzes and surveys, no, where attacker seemingly uses or utilizes yung mga harmless quizzes or surveys na yan, no, to collect personal information. You know, there are several surveys, no, or there are several quizzes available online, no, na pwede nating sagutin, minsan alam natin kikita tayo or pwedeng pagkakitaan, no, or hindi naman kaya is parang kumbaga is just to have an access of an information which we are answering survey. Well, I'm not saying basically that masama or hindi dapat tayo sumagot sa mga survey because there are legitimate surveys and there are legitimate quizzes, no? But we must be mindful on what information are we providing, no? Dapat mindful tayo kung ano lang yung limitation na pwede nating i-allow, no, na information na pwede nating i-provide. Say for example, your name, no? Are you willing to give your name, no? For me, okay lang siguro yan if that's the name. Birthday, no? Birthday, medyo alanganin na yan kasi they could you know, maaring lang, maaring pwedeng magamit nila ang aking birthday to have an idea on my password, pin code, something like that. So, medyo alanganin akong magbigay ng birthday, no? Although I'm not saying that my password is my birthday, but, no, it has a value, no? May value talaga yung birthday mo, no? Kaya mahalaga yun. Kaya wag nating ino-open access ang ating mga birthday, no? So, yun yung pwede nating maaring gawin, no? Para makaiwas tayo sa possible attacks, no? Through social engineering. It is okay if you're answering quizzes or surveys, no? You're providing your information, but be mindful on what you are sharing, no? Make sure that those information that you're sharing will not be useful for the cyber criminals to exploit you, no? Yun yung tandaan pa natin. Okay, then we have also yung tinatawag nating baiting, no? The attackers offer something enticing such as free software or USB drive, no, with the malware to trick individuals into compromising their system, no? Kumbaga, baiting, from the word baiting, is they're giving enticing bait, no? Yung parang nakaka-entice, no? Kumbaga is mapapa-uka na lang. Say for example is They're providing free cell phone or free laptop. Just click on the link, no? Just provide your information. Just provide this information, mga ganun. Now, so some people, no, would definitely take advantage of those. Kasi sino ba naman ang may ayon ng free laptop, free cell phone, and so on? Eh, maglalagin ka lang doon, magbigay ka lang ng mga information mo, and so on. And sometimes, you know, parang hindi naman siya talaga kasuspe-suspecha, no? Kasi paano nila malalaman yung access, yung login credentials mo? Ilalagin mo lang naman doon, din nila masisilip, no? But that is a wrong conception, no? Basically, kapag in-enter mo ang iyong login credential on a fake website, no, created by hackers, they will have an access on your login credentials. So mag-ingat-ingat po tayo, no? So some people are really drawn onto that. Basta may free, may libre, may discount, something like that, is they're willing to compromise their system. No, kumbaga is nawawala na yung pagiging vigilant nila, no? Hindi na sila nagiging maingat. So ang end, no, it end up that their security are being compromised. So those are some of the methods of social engineering. So sinasabi natin, sino ba ang pwedeng maging targets dito? Well, marami ang pwedeng maging targets, no? Individuals are included, tayo bilang individual, no? Employees, most likely employees, no? Or even an entire organization can be subjected to a social engineering attack, no? First is yung attackers will exploit, no, yung trust, no. Then sometimes they take advantage also of the human error, no. But one thing is for sure, no, with regards to social engineering, is they're targeting those weakest link in the organization, no. Those who have access. The social engineering schemes does not really go on to have a massive attack, no. Hindi yung kumbaga is mag-send siya ng messages, no, sa lahat ng empleyado, no. Hindi, pipiliin lang yung kumbaga sino ba sa kanila ang may access, may possible access sa ganitong information, no? Sino ba sa kanila ang pwede na or madali nating papaniwalain or madali nating i-exploit. So they are taking advantage of all these things in order to perform the so-called social engineering. Okay, I have included examples in your module. Like for example, we have here example number 1, the phony technical support calls. Yan po yung mga tumatawag na mga kunyari or technical support calls, no. Then they will, you know, magpanggap sila ng mga technical service, technical supports, no. And they will be asking for a remote access to your computer, and if you provide your remote access to them, no? Pag sinabi kasi nating remote access, ibig pong sabihin yan is they will have an access on your gadget, on your computer, even if you are not meeting face to face, no? So through internet or through the cyber connectivity, is that they will have an access on your desktop, and that's really dangerous. We should not be willingly just give remote access to just anyone, no, that we meet online. So wag na wag po nating gagawin yan, yung magbigay ng remote access, because there are some people who are really taking advantage of that. Okay, and we have also the CEO fraud, no. Attackers impersonate high-ranking executives within an organization. We made mention of this on the method number 2, yung impersonation. Magpanggap po sila ng mga high-ranking executives or officials of your organization, no? And then later on, they would be asking, no, personal information or confidential information about the organization, no? And if you provide one, then definitely your security is already compromised, okay? The next is we have here phishing attack, no? When we talk about phishing attack, phishing is a specific type of social engineering. So it's still an example of social engineering, no? However, here, the attackers use a deceptive emails, messages, websites, trick individuals into providing sensitive information. No? So, sa phishing attack is, from the concept itself, phishing, yung sabi nga natin kanina, phishing, no? They're phishing for information, not really yung phishing na pangingisda, pero the same concept, as I made mention, that they're trying to gain access, no? Or gain information by randomly sending, no? Itong mga pretext messages, no? Or website. The idea here is that you trick people, you trick individuals into providing sensitive information. Now, we have here several methods of phishing attack. Now, we have email phishing, spear phishing, smishing, vishing. Now, what are those? So, for email phishing, it's very obvious from the term itself, email phishing. Now, attackers send here fraudulent emails that appears legitimate. No, they often mimic. No, ginagaya nila yung mga trusted entities gaya ng banks, no, government agencies or some other reputable companies. No, as I've stated, there's a way for you to check onto the email. You always look at the URL. If the URL is indeed legitimate, then definitely it is legitimate, no? Kung government agencies yan, alam po natin that government agencies at the URL, no? .com, .ph, no? .gov.ph, they have that as part of their URL, no? Kung institution yan, no? May .edu.ph, no? Yun yung mga tandaan natin. Kung email yan, no? It's either at email.com or at gmail.com. Anything that goes, no, beyond that, yung mga that hot, that mail, mga ganun, most likely are email phishing, no, activities. They're not legitimate URLs, no. So, yun yung tignan natin para makaiwas tayo dyan. So, do not believe, no, face value, yung mga nare-receive nating mga emails. Always try to check, no, on their URLs, no, or to check whether they're legitimate or not legitimate. Okay, then we have also spear phishing, no, targeted form of phishing where attackers customize their approach based on specific information about individuals or organization. Here, no, sa spear phishing, the concept here is that it is customized, no? Sometimes you receive an email na nakalagay doon, good day, ma'am, sir, no? Something like that. That's email phishing because that's a general. No? The term that is being used is general. No? They're not sure if that's ma'am or sir. Diba? Pag nagsend sila ng email, hindi sigurado kung sino makaka-receive. They put a general term, like for example, good day user, good day subscriber, good day ma'am, sir. No, those are general, no. For spear phishing, ang pinagkaiba niyan is it's already customized. So for example, your name is Pedro, so they will write an email on you or they will send you a text message na nakalagay yun, good morning Pedro. No? So it's very customized based on the available information, and sometimes, no, people would be more enticed to respond to those images at to those emails, no, yung mga naka-customize, kumbaga, ay, kasi iba kasi yung impact nun, eh. Pag halimbawa naka-receive ka ng email nandun sa heading yung pangalan mo, like good morning Mr. Pedro, something like that, so you're more enticed to cooperate. So sometimes, no, yung mga cyber attackers natin would customize their emails, no, for that reason, no, na para makakuha sila ng response, no, para sa mga target nila, they will customize their emails, no, that they are sending. So if it's customized, sometimes yung mga tao, no, are more enticed to participate. So be careful also with regards to that. Okay? Then we have also the so-called smishing. No, smishing, it's a form of phishing conducted through SMS, no, or text messages from the word smish, no, SM, no, parang SMS phishing. So this shortcut term for that, smishing. No? So ito yung mga phishing attack na gumagamit or ang ginagamit naman po nila ay mga text messages. They have the same concept. Ganun pa rin yun, no? They're sending you text messages for them to sending you text messages, no? And they will be asking for a confidential information, no, that they could use to exploit your security and something like that. So phishing po naman is a phishing attacks conducted over phone call, no? So voice call phishing, no? It's a voice call phishing. Ito na yung mga mismong tumatawag na, no, nakikipag-usap na, naririnig mo na yung mga boses nila, kausap mo na sila, no, and they will be asking for a information. We need to be careful with regards to phishing kasi with the advancement of technologies already right now, as I've stated, nag-advance ang technology natin and there are applications already or methods that they can use to mimic, no? To mimic a certain voice na mangopya sila ng boses, no? Sila ay magpanggap na sino, no? Gamit ang isang boses na hindi naman nila boses pero boses siguro ng kakilala mo, something like that. So yan yung mga advancement on the technologies that cyber criminals are also taking advantage, which make it more and more complicated now to deal with this, no? So lagi tayong mag-iingat. Si for example, may tumawag sa'yo, no, from an unknown number na nagpapanggap na sa ganito, no? If that's an unknown number, it means that you need to verify whether it is really him through his personal number, no? Or always verify kung yung taong kausap mo nga ba talaga is siya talaga yon, no? So, yun yung mga pag-iingat na pwede natin gawin para hindi tayo mabiktima ng mga ganitong schemes, no? So, the target of phishing attack could be anyone, no? Could be an individual, it could be an employee, it could be an organization, whether a big organization or a small organization, no? And their purpose is usually to gain unauthorized access to accounts, no? Steal datas, no? Or deploy malwares into your system. So, yun yung mga possible things na pwede nilang gawin, no? So we have here examples of phishing. We have credential phishing. We have invoice pay or payment scam. We have COVID-19 related scam, something like that. So with regards to credential phishing, no, attackers create a fake login pages, no, to trick individuals into entering their usernames and passwords. Say for example is your bank account, no. For example, makareceive ka ng email na ikaw ay nakatanggap ng 10,000 pesos and you need to log in on the link provided to check on your account, no, something like that. Those are sometimes phishing, no. Huwag kang gagamit or gumamit ng ibang link, no, to log in into your bank accounts or into your other accounts, no. You always use the legitimate application, no. If say for example that's Land Bank, ba't ka mag-log in doon sa Land Bank mo gamit ang link provided sa'yo ng isang email, if you can just go on into your mobile app, no, doon sa phone mo, and you can log in there on your own, no, without using others' link from suspicious people. So, yun yung mga pwede nating pag-iingat dyan, no? Same as true with invoice or payment scam, no? Phishing emails may pose as invoice or payment request, no? Directing individuals to fraudulent websites. Say, for example, bigla ka naka-receive ng email na overdue na yung iyong bill, no? Meron kang babayarang bill na mag-overdue and you need to settle immediately or you need to cancel before mag-manifest yung transaction, na halimbawa is naka-receive ka ng email na sabi that you are sending an amount of 1,000 pesos to this account, click on the link to cancel the transaction if it's not here, something like that, and then you log in there, no, doon sa link provided. That could be a just a phishing attack, no, pwedeng phishing attack yan. As again, now always use yung trusted application ninyo, on your phone. Now, don't use any other links, no, para ikaw ay maka-access sa iyong mga accounts, bank accounts, no, GCash, e-wallet accounts, and something like that. So, to avoid falling as a victim of phishing attack. Okay? Same as true with COVID-19 related scam during the pandemic, no, yung mga attackers, no, capitalizes on the fears and uncertainties using phishing emails related to COVID-19 updates, vaccine information, and so on. So, yun yung mga possible example natin for phishing attack. There's a way for us to avoid becoming or falling as a victim, no, of phishing attack and as well as social engineering attack. And number one is, of course, education. We need to be educated regarding these matters, no. Use of security tools. We need to be aware also. We need to be familiar on how we protect ourselves using yung mga available security tools online, no, such as email filters, web filters, antivirus softwares, and so on. And also two-factor authentication or 2FA, no. I hope you're already adding extra layer to your security with 2FA, no. Although minsan tinatamad tayong set ng ating 2FA, no, but it really is effective kasi at least we have a extra layer of security, no. Say for example your security, your login credentials were already compromised, no, so long as you still have 2FA two-factor authentication, no, enabled on your system, hindi pa rin sila magkakaroon ng access unless you give them access, no. And also vigilance, no. Vigilance is that we need to encourage a culture of skepticism and caution. You know, it's not wrong to always ask question, no. Hindi masama yung maging mapagduda or mapaghinala tayo with regards to online schemes, no. Halimbawa, nakatanggap ka ng 1,000 pesos, something like that. Always na kailangan meron lagi tayong pagdududa, no. Why? That is being vigilant. No, because if we are not being vigilant, we might fall as victim of these cyber attacks. Okay? So that ends with regards to our topic with social engineering and phishing attack. No? Let's continue with DDoS attack on another lecture. Thank you for listening, guys. No, I hope you are listening well for to our discussion so that we will be ready because the midterm is already fast approaching. Okay? If you have questions, no, just leave questions on the GC for that matter, no, sa para masagot natin. Thank you. Goodbye.